Hey, so finally your wait is over for NSEGS, that's National Standard Examination in Junior Science. I hope your exam went well and we are here with the recorded video solutions for the same. And for our discussion, we will be picking up the code 52 and I will be discussing the physics part of this paper with all of you. Now let's jump into the discussion of the very first question of physics. So this question says apple dropping from apple tree were observed by many people before Newton. But why they fall was explained only by Isaac Newton postulating the law of universal gravitation that we all know. Which of the following statements best describes the situation? The first option says the force of gravity acts only on the apple, which is wrong. The second option says the apple is attracted towards the surface of the earth. Option 3 says both earth and apple experiences the same force of attraction towards each other. Option D says apple falls due to earth's gravity and hence only option A is true and C is absurd. Now out of these four options, option C is the correct option. Why? Because we know from the law of gravitation that it's attractive in nature, and when this force acts, it acts on both the object, and the magnitude of this force is the same for both the objects which are included in the interaction. So basically both earth and apple experiences the same force of attraction towards each other. This statement is absolutely right, which makes this option to be the correct option for this question. I hope this question is pretty clear to you. Moving on to the discussion for the next question. So this question says a rectangular metal plate shown in the adjacent figure has a charge of 420 microcoulomb. So we are given this plate. Let's have a look onto it. So this is the metal plate over which the charge is given. How much charge is given? Let's mark that also. So 420 microcoulomb is the charge that is given to this metal plate. Further, the question says assumed to be uniformly distributed over it. So we need to assume that this charge that we have given to the metal plate is uniformly distributed all over the area of the plate. Then how much is the charge over the shaded area? You can clearly see in this figure that this is the shaded area. We need to find out the charge which is in this shaded area. Further, the question says no part of metal plate is cut. Here circles and the diagonals are shown for clarity only, and the value of pi is 22/7. So basically in this question what we are supposed to do is we need to find out the charge that is lying in this shaded area. Now here to find out that, first of all we need to find out charge per unit area. Okay, so see here, this is a rectangular plate. We are given the length and the breadth also. We are given the charge, which is 420 microcoulomb. So we can easily find out in the solution of this question charge per unit area. We can easily calculate that. That is Q by A. What is the charge given to the plate? That's 420 microcoulomb. And the area of the plate will be 28 into 14. So this will be 420 divided by 28 into 14 microcoulomb per centimeter square. So this is the charge per unit area. Now we need to find out the shaded region first. Then we will multiply the area of the shaded region with this charge per unit area, and our job is done. So to find out the shaded area, I can write down shaded area is equal to area of this triangle. See here, this triangle I am talking about. Area of this triangle, which will be half into base into height. So that will be half into 28 into 14 minus, we need to subtract this area. Now when you will add these two, this will make one complete circle. So you need to subtract the area of the circle, which will be pi r square. So this will be 22/7 into r square. Now how you are going to get the radius of this circle? See here, from here till here, What is this length? That's 28. Now this 28 will be equal to the diameter, the sum of the diameter of these two circles which are identical. So the radius will come out to be 7. Okay. So I can write again this as half into 28 into 14 minus 22 by 7 into 7 square, and when I'll subtract or when I'll calculate this, this will come out to be 42 centimeter square. Now charge in the shaded region will be equal to 42 into 420 divided by 28 into 14, that will be equal to 45 microcoulomb. So let's have a look on to the different options with that we are given here. So as you can see, option A is the correct option for this question. So I hope this question is also very clear to you. We are done with the solution of this part also. Let's move on to the next question for our discussion. That's question number 3. Hey, so now here we have question number 3 for our discussion, which says in the adjacent circuit the voltages across AD, BD and CD are, we are mentioned here these voltages, that's 2 volt, 6 volt and 8 volt across AD, BD and CD respectively. So we are given this figure. Across AD, as per the question, the voltage is 2 volt. Across BD, it means across these two, the sum of the voltages across these two is given to us. I am just going to mark this like this. So this is 6 volt that's given to us in the question, and the voltage across CD is 8 volt. It means the voltage that this cell is providing to this circuit is 8 volt. Now we need to find out the value of RB and RC. Let's solve this question. See here, we can easily solve this question. We are given this total voltage, which is 8 volt. We are given the value of RA also. See here, it's mentioned that if RA is 1 kilo ohm. So if RA is 1 kilo ohm, I can easily find out the current that is flowing through the circuit. So here I am quickly going to write down the solution for the same. So current will be, from Ohm's law, it will be V by R. What is V? That's 2 and the resistance is 1 kilo ohm. So this will simply be 2 milliampere. Now the current of milliampere is flowing through. So this is going to be the direction of the current. So this is 2 milliampere is the current that is flowing through the circuit. 2 milliampere is the current that is flowing through RB also. We can easily find out the voltage across RB. See here. Here it's 2 volt. So when you will subtract 2 from 6, it will be 4 volt. Now you know the current that is flowing through RB, that is 2 milliampere. Again applying Ohm's law here, you will find out the value of RB, that will come out to be, RB will be V by I or VB by I. What is VB? We have calculated, it's 4 volt. And the current is 2 milliampere. So this comes out to be 2 kilo ohm. This is small k. If you have a look onto the options, you can see only in option 2, that is in option B, the value of RB is given to us as 2 kilo ohm. So I am just going to mark this option to be the right one. There is no need to find out RC also, because in none of the options, the value of RB is given to us as 2 kilo ohm. So it is only mentioned in option B, and hence we are going to save our time here. So this is the correct option for this question. I hope this question is also very clear to you. Let's move on to the discussion for the next question.